right. I'm not sure if streaming in landscape was the best move, actually, but morning practice session. And I have a new project going on with some Paganini. So get some sound going here. It gets up there. It gets up there. North Carolina, and these guys, two set violin, this YouTube channel, great YouTube channel, go check them out. Kind of got on my radar recently, and I started working on some classical music. I forgot how much I loved it, and maybe I can give you an idea of what this looks like. Yeah, scary. But scary, if I guess, if you've never seen it before. Classical musicians seen this kind of stuff all the time. Check out Cole. Sleeping through it all like a champ. And yeah, it's the staccato, which is really tough. Like, and the violin technique and the bowing technique and the size of the instrument, all these challenges that I'm coming across trying to play that music by just plucking with the right hand. See if you can get a little shot of the right hand there. Do classical composers not use a rest? That's a good question, actually. Not with a violin in this case. Yeah, the album with Tim Miller and Dennis Chambers is not coming out. That's kind of all I can say about it. So I've been trying to work on it, like, just staccato. Kind of tough. Especially when you have to do leaps like that. This is a kind of a tough passage. As simple as it is harmonically, I mean, it's all pretty simple, you know, harmonic kind of content. It's just like, let's see, I got tons of questions coming in here. It's probably not a good idea to do a Q&A at the same time I'm practicing. But I notice it's not that dissimilar from some of the exercises I use, like practice exercise, warm-up exercises, that kind of stuff. So the two worlds are not that far away, but just the articulation is a real challenge. Like that stuff, especially like when you're playing across arpeggios and you want to keep them ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta and not let any notes ring on. Come on. See, that's what I'm saying. Like, it's only a major arpeggio. And another major arpeggio. That was like a 5 and a 1. Do you think it would be easier if the bass was tuned in fifths like the violins are? Good question. I don't know. It's all relative, right? Like, what's, if you know, if that's what you do, if you're a violinist and you're playing fifths all the time, Maybe. I'm a bass player. I play in fourths. So I haven't really thought about that. Good question. And I just started learning the notes for the first... I never played this before last night, so I just started learning the notes, trying to memorize just the first kind of main passage where it gets rolling here. And so for that, it's good as well, for memorizing stuff. Pretty good exercise. God, this chair is so squeaky. New chair coming soon. For all coffee drinkers who know about the bloody squeak on this chair. Like that stuff. To really play that clean, the rolling of the wrist, like that technique. See how my hand is kind of slightly coming off? There are like these, all these subtle movements with the left hand. Can I, what is going on here with this? I hate the fact that it's backwards, that I'm left-handed. And I thought I figured this out the last time I did this. Maybe it's not for you guys, maybe it's just me. We'll see afterwards. Like the linear stuff, or the really close, you know, the arpeggios that only take up two strings. Pretty easy, like that major one. But as soon as you skip three strings, or half a neck, it gets a little weird. And really dialing in, maybe I can pull the chair up a little bit, maybe dialing in, really dialing in the fingering on the left hand. I had to really put that under the microscope. Especially playing way up the range of the instrument. I have 28 frets on here, so I have a high E. Low E to C with 28 frets gives me an E. Not particularly in tune one right now, still got to work on the intonation. That exact part. It's lifting the lower notes off once I've played them and putting them back down. That's the hard part. So just play them multiple times each. Trying to play this like to be some kind of classical musician. It's just a really nice challenge, some great shapes and things that really challenge my technique. Is the way I hold the bass like a classical guitar a problem on gigs sometimes where I have to stand? No, not really. Pretty comfortable. Just maybe a little lower when I stand. It depends on the strap length, but no, it's not a problem at all. Just missing notes there. Wrong. Wrong. Sound. Okay. easy to, you know, how do you apply this kind of language into a jazz context? Easy. It's just chord tones at the end of the day. So that's five. It's one. A lot of one minor there. 5-7 or 4. It's all 5-1. So that's A7 to D minor, G, C, E. So like E to E7 to, or G sharp diminished to A minor, E. E7, back to 1 again. And you can just analyze it like that. I'm not really analyzing, I'm just hearing all the like 5-1 and the basic progressions. I like that descending thing. Look at that, that's... It's 5-1. That's just 1 flat 7 5 3 of the G to 1. That's where I've got as far as memorizing the stuff so far. But yeah, it's all 5-1, basically. Nothing crazy, nothing like, if you just go slow and check each note out and really figure. Actually quite simple, just the fact that it should be played at about 144 BPM, which is crazy fast. I'm not even gonna play the recording. That's tough. So 2.5 octave. Yeah. Different ways to play. I've still got to work on that fingering. That's probably the easiest. Just the biggest skip in the bottom. One jump. And I've been like repeating stuff as well. Just creating exercises out of it. Really good for independence. Recently got all the good stuff, thumbs up. What book do you suggest I get next? All the good stuff. Well, all the good stuff is the first one in that series. There's all the better stuff. That's like the next one in that series. I just put out a book all about 251s. I guess after this goes, gets uploaded to the server and stays there for everyone to watch after it's live, I'll put the links below. That's Jazz Vocabulary for Electric Bass. A lot of this stuff, I've been working on that. Like 251 stuff, and then I got to this classical thing, thanks to Two Set Violin guys. And they're very similar. Like I said, all this stuff is 5 to 1. How to practice paying attention. Wow. That's just your will. Your will to learn, I guess. And how much you're into it. Like, I'm way into this. I think Chelsea's really happy she has a gig today and has to leave early so she doesn't have to listen to me practicing.
No, I love it.
Why
don't you use the baby elephant?
Oh, yeah, I did use the baby elephant. I'm just going to demonstrate that for YouTube, babe. It was pretty horrible, I got to say. I used the baby elephant. It doesn't even track. Ah. But it did give me the kind of range of the violin. Anyway, that was the one thing she didn't like about it. But she's also threatening to pull out her violin. And that's literal, that's not a metaphor. And play some Paganini. Maybe we'll play this in unison at some point. That'll be a podcast. Actually, we'll just hire two people and be on the podcast, because podcast is like radio, and then nobody will be able to see. Is Christmas in LA weird, given how crappy the weather is here in the UK? I don't know. I've lived here so long. Chelsea's lived here her whole life. And Christmas Day is also her birthday, so it's like actually nice to have sun on your birthday.
No.
Okay, apparently not. What's the best piece of advice you ever got from a jazz great? Jeez. I have to think about that one. Now I can't even practice. And I've been working with the metronome a lot. I started down around 60 BPM. I'm up to about 100 now, but the metronome's in my phone. So I can't stream from the phone and use the metronome at the same time. What days am I going to be at the NAMM show? All of them, I think. Maybe not Sunday, but Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Getting distracted as well. Getting that transition, not good. Let's see. About the night shows, I will be at exactly 0 night shows for NAMM. 0. I gotta make a conscious effort to get that. Okay, now I feel it. Sometimes it's about planting the, just one note will change the way I approach something and have a concept to like fix an issue. Like I was really messing up getting to that G7 sound. And I just found I need to plant my second finger a little stronger on that G to make the foundation of the chord. Like that. How clean was that now? Little details like that that get you kind of going in the right direction when you're practicing something. It's so subtle, but that's when you find out whether your pinky and your ring finger on the left hand are really working, and whether they're independent of each other, and you can get these 2-4 and 1-3 shapes. So 3-1-2-4. And also like the extending of playing four notes on one string. And whether you slide to there or just move up with the same string. When does my new signature bass come out? Nam Sho. Am I usually practicing one thing at a time for the most part? I'm missing questions. Oh, hang on a second. All messages are visible. Oh, here we go. Hey, Yannick, I put in an order with Anders. Oh, I gotta, hang on a second. Can't see. How's the development coming on it? The four string you demoed is sounding nice. Yeah, the master built five strings. He's in the process of building. Any orders that have come in, he's making them right now. I know that. And the four string sounds great as well. I really dig the four string, especially the neck on it. It's badass. But obviously the five string as well. This is my main instrument, so. Where will I be able to order it in Europe? You can order it right from mathisonbass.com. Just send Matt Anders an email. Now, it felt a lot better taking a few seconds away from it, talking, and then coming back, so. Miss. Wrong. Any tips on working on your new book, 251? I got the video yesterday as well. Cool. Thanks for picking that up. I mean, just, well, I start at the beginning for sure and see where you're at. Like, test your ability, see if you can get through those exercises, see if you can really do them in 12 keys. Can I do them in 12 keys? And then we'll remove in cycle of fourths, maybe. You know, around the instrument and go at your own pace. It's a great thing about a book. Nobody's forcing you. There's no timeline. You can go at your own pace. Oh. It's like 2 p.m. here right now. Been going at this for 4 hours. Any more guests planned for the podcast? Absolutely. My star guest is about to go out for a gig. But, huh?
Adios.
Adios. Mi amor. Hasta luego. Hasta noche, ¿no? So, yeah, I would say, who else is coming up? I don't know. Tons of people I want to get on there. Timmy, I want Tim LaFave to be on there. Mickey Madden from Maroon 5 was a fantastic bass player. A lot of bass players, but all kinds of people. Yes, so yes, to answer your question, lots more people planned to be on the podcast. I hope to get people like Benny Greb and people from, like, you know, that don't live here in LA when they're in town for the NAMM show. So I'm hoping I'll be doing a lot of podcasting that week. Probably get Henrik Linder, Benny Greb, Mickey Madden, Tim LaFave, you know, maybe a Nathan East or a Will Lee if he's in town for NAMM. Who knows? I like sitting and talking to my friends, so as long as they're around, I'm sure it won't be an issue. The other thing is, I don't think there's a lot of hammering going on. I got to check out. Listen to the articulation of somebody really good playing this music. So I don't think I can get away with hammering stuff. I think that might be cheating with the left hand. Mm, Prices on the signature basis. Yeah. Well, yeah, we made a video about that. I think that is on. Yeah. So many questions coming in. 25 words or less. Can you summarize what 2019 will have in store for you? Musical goals, et cetera, et cetera. 2019. I think the biggest focus of 2019 is having an amazing wedding in August. What do you reckon, babe? I just got the thumbs up. So I think that's the biggest focus of 2019. Already there's a lot of touring on the books, both for me and for Chelsea, so. 2019, holding it together while we both crisscross timelines and locations as we're touring. I also feel like I'm getting to the end of my tolerance for playing this material. Now it's been like 4 hours I've spent pretty much nonstop on this. So either I need to go way slower. Or just switch up and do something else. Messy. Well, babe, you going? I'll see you later. From the rigidness of practicing something classical like that and get into actually working on, something. that's enough for today. See you guys soon. Coffee drinkers.